do the hip shimmy, which is also known as the American shimmy. I'll call it the loose hip shimmy, because you really see the hip moving. So in order to see your hip moving up and down, you really need to bend those knees. Bend the knees, and now you're gonna go up, left, right. So the knee stays bent. You don't overextend the knee, back like this, they stay bent. See how it stays bent? The hip goes up and down. So next, hip sway. The hip sway goes up, down, up, down. Keep those knees bent. Again, don't overextend the knee. That'll make it look different and awkward. So it's a nice flow. So it's a nice hip sway going up and down. Now, I'm gonna go a little bit faster. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. And a bit faster. Go towards the back. So again, knees are bent. Start bringing your right hip underneath the rib cage and left. Now let's go a bit faster. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. So you really want to see those hips moving up and down. Okay, so it's not Egyptian. It's hip. It's all in the hip. This one is great when we start doing three-quarter shimmy. It's great for tribal fusion. It's great to walk. It's great to go on a releve. So when I say releve, you put all the weight on the big toes towards the ball of your feet. The heel stays up and you can walk. Okay, but that's more advanced. Right now I want you to focus on just bending those knees, keep those knees bent, and hip going up and down. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. And then you go as fast as you can. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Keep those knees bent. Really want to see those hips moving up and down. All right, good job.